Okay, so without further ado, let's go and head towards our first destination, and that will be the Bell of Awakening that's up above waiting for us. And there will be a lot of crap in the way, so I hope I can make it through unscathed. Well, unscathed is probably not the way to put it, but... come on. Okay, no, okay, I'm not going to be parrying this. Just die. By the way, just before you ask, no, I'm not doing that jump, because I've done it before, and it's either 50-50 for me. God. Okay, bring it. And... dead. There we go. You know what? Normally, I wouldn't mind you throwing that stuff at me, and I would go, you know what, I'm gonna get it anyway. Just make sure you don't hit me. He almost did. Well, thank you for missing, at least. Come on. What are you doing? He really thinks he can sneak up on me like that. Oh, why wasn't that a backstab? Interesting. You know, I already took way more damage than I wanted to, and that's why the unscathed bit was a bit of a far stretch. Soul of a Lost Undead. We're going to be reading a lot of item descriptions too. Because one thing... you know what? I've never been poisoned by that rat before. Never. And now I have to get poisoned. But what I wanted to say is we're going to read some items descriptions here and there. Because I have a lot of friends that played this game and stopped playing this game because they said, oh, there's no story to it. And that's because you're not reading item descriptions. When is this poison gonna stop? It's probably going to take a really long time before it stops, doesn't it? Okay, we gotta keep healing, I guess. And that doesn't really help me. I can't afford to be hit because I'm going to lose all my Estus before I even reach the next bonfire. And roll backwards before that guy hits us. Ooh, that tracking though. Oh man, I can already hear Red laughing at me for getting poisoned. Okay, was there anything here? I doubt it, but might as well check. Sometimes it does help to break all these boxes and barrels because there could be something hidden in them. Most of the time, it's not the case though. Soul of a Lost Undead. We're getting a lot of souls, which is good because we need a couple more levels so we can use our next weapon. Also, hi to you. Jesus Christ, this poison takes forever. I've never been poisoned this long in this game. Let's kill this guy before we get hit by an arrow. Or that guy. Just keep dodging. I don't... how did that guy get that message to float like that? That's my question. Let's go kill that guy before we open this door. And there we go. Oh! He ain't dead! I actually thought he was dead. Great, 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 great. I know there is a shield in here, I just don't know if it's any good though. Wooden shield. And I'm not going to read it right now because I fear I might die in the process of reading it. I hate these guys. I totally hate these guys. Okay, the poison stopped, which is good. Let's see, does this help? A little. Not much, though. There's no real... Oh, he almost got me. He almost got me, that dick. I know I can kick their shields away, but most of the time they're being dicks and they'll poke me right as I do it. Oh, wait, the poison is gone, so we can actually read some item descriptions here. There we go. Shield, attack style, strike. Vertically elongated wooden shield decorated with a white dragon. Wooden or wood shields are lighter than metal shields, but with lower physical damage reduction and reduced shield stability. Sadly, it doesn't have much lore on it, but I do like it for a wooden shield, but we won't be wearing this for too long, so let's continue on. You know, that guy, I can't remember how many times, but that guy got me so many times on my first playthrough. Oh, and apparently he's still getting away with it. And also, this was my first jump scare in this game. Like, holy crap, that guy got me good.
Well now, you seem to have your wits about you, hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Everything is for sale, eh? So let me see what you got. There is one thing in particular I want from this guy. Although, I also think he drops it if you kill it. And he has some really good weapons here, he actually does, but there's one weapon in particular that I want from him, and the only way for me to get it is through other means.
What a waste of time. Go and fall off a cliff.
Yeah, he isn't the nicest. Try stabbing in the back.
Oh, you again. I hope you've brought plenty of souls. Things are getting treacherous in these parts. A horrible goat demon has moved in below. And up above, there's that humongous drake and a bull demon too. If you stick around this place, it might end up being your grave.
I like how talking to NPCs can actually really help you out in this game, because he already gave us kind of like three hints on bosses that are going to be done through this playthrough. A goat demon, a bull demon, and that drake that kind of cut us off in our path earlier when we tried to cross that bridge.
Yeah, I'm not here to chit chat. We talk business or we talk nothing at all. Yeah, I'm not here to chit chat. We talk business or we talk nothing at all.
Okay, if that's how you want it.
Throw me a bone, will you? You haven't got much time anyway. Right, Yulia?
He keeps saying Yulia, right? And first, I always thought he was maybe talking about this barrel kind of idea, because he keeps stroking it for some reason. But recently, I found out he was talking about something else. And we're going to find out in a second. Let's heal up. He might even kick our ass, you know that? But here we go. I'm sorry, dude, but you're not really helping me out.
You've gone mad, have you? I'll teach you, you laugh.
Why me, little Yulia?
Yulia. And I really think that he was talking about this weapon, though. Katana forged in an eastern land. Known for his brisk slashing motion, the Uchi Katana cuts beautifully and causes bleeding, but its blade is easily nicked. And this is the weapon I wanted, but we can't use it yet. So we're going to head to the second bonfire here. Well, it's kind of the first bonfire in this area, but the second bonfire if you count Firelink Shrine. And sit down and hope we can actually level up enough to use it. I doubt it, but we can try. And if not, we have some souls we can actually use. Level up. We need two more levels to do this, so I'm going to try that. And... oh, wait. Oh, we already have it on our hotbar. I like the Dark Souls 2 way better. You can actually, say, use all four of them at the same time, because this is pretty time-consuming. Do I have any more of those? No, I don't. What we are going to do is we're going to reverse reverse hollowing has to be done by first using a humanity. Because even though it's kind of cool to be an undead, but it can be an eyesore. And now we're human again. What this does, it will also allow us to be invaded, and it will allow us to summon people to help us out a little bit here and there. Oh shit, I forgot about that second guy. Bring it! What was that? I thought I heard something behind us. And I'm going to kill some enemies here at the start. Uh-oh. That actually did not hurt as much as I thought it would, actually. And especially because they die in one hit. Would that be enough? We can take a look if that's enough to get another two levels out of it so we can use that new weapon. Let's see, level up. Ah shit, we're just a little bit short. Seeing that we sat down, we can just kill him again real fast. Let's rush this guy. And wait for that guy to stop his frenzy. We need like 800, 900 to do this, so... we gotta kill a couple more. Let's kill these guys, even though it's not the fastest way, but... there we go. Now we should have more than enough to do it. And we're actually going to head back to Firelink Shrine in a bit, I think, because there's something I would like to get. Also, that would mean our first suicide run of the game. But I think I could manage a little bit without. I'm not sure. I'll try. And we'll see what happens. So now we got the Uchi Katana, we can actually use it. The moveset on this thing is really good. Really, really good. And it's just, it's something different. And that guy just killed himself. Oh. Jesus Christ, just die already. Are you actually coming up here? Let's try two-handing it and see how this goes. I killed him, although I couldn't really show off the move that I was trying to do. Ooh! I thought I would hit you, at least. No? Okay. Roll. I don't want to die here, even though it's imminent. Ooh! It's not as strong as the club, but I just like the moveset on this. Okay, cannot open from this side. And I love the ragdolls in this game. That always makes me so happy to see those ragdolls again. And that guy could get a lot of new players. He got me the first time. He actually killed me the first time I got here. What was this again? Black fire bombs, which can actually help us out a lot. There is an enemy coming up, and I'm not sure if I am going to be fighting that enemy, but... oh! I forgot that guy was throwing fire bombs. You're not getting me that easily. And just because we can, we're going to go up here real fast and kill the enemies up here. I don't know if there are any items. Oh, there is, actually. Oh, no, no, no. I actually thought he would throw firebombs at- oh, this guy's going to throw some. At least the backstabs kill in one hit. But at least I have a little bit more range too. And we got our first piece of armor, which I'm not going to wear, I think. Oh, maybe. Let's see. Helm worn by hollow warriors. Although it is made of iron, it is old, battered, and worn out. It is wise to wear a sturdy form of head protection against arrows and other physical threats. It doesn't look that good. So I'm going to stay naked, basically. And we're going to head in here. Oh, before we do that, this guy could cause for a lot of heartache. Oh, he almost got me there. Because he will snipe the hell out of you from up here. And sadly, yes, that was another death that I encountered before in this game. Being sniped in the frickin' ass by that guy. Gold pine resin. This will save a lot of trouble in a bit. So I'm going to get rid of this for now and this. Put the gold pine resin on. Rare pine resin, which emits golden sparks. Apply lightning to right-hand weapon. Affected weapon inflicts rare lightning damage, making it effective against targets which are resilient to both magic and fire. Very effective against dragon family foes. Thank you very much. We'll be using that in a bit. There's an enemy down here. Down in that alleyway. I'm not too sure if I'm going to fight him now because he's a huge pain in the ass. And he will most likely kill me in some way. And just because I don't like these guys. Let's see if this actually helps. Yeah, it does. Oh shit, that actually helped too. Nice blocking. You know, if I... Oh, I'll probably wear that. Look, that's what I like about enemies in this game. If you decide to heal up during a battle, they will most likely take that opportunity and attack you while you're vulnerable. But you can do the same with them. Waistcloth worn by hollow soldiers. It is so tattered that it barely serves its purpose anymore. But it looks better than nothing, I guess. Let's fight our way up here. Gotta be careful though, because this hurts if you don't get out of the way. Let him come to us. I so love this moveset, man. Ugh. So satisfying to kill something with this weapon. Ring ahead. Which is true. There is a ring ahead. But we're not going down there. I just wanted to open it. There is an enemy down there that can kind of one-shot me at this point. And I don't want to deal with that at the moment because I want to at least get through this part. And in this barrel is something we will need. Ah, come on! Come on, just die. I almost lost him though. Twinkling Titanite and Titanite Chunk. Whoa, a chunk? Oh, that's pretty damn good. And those are upgrade materials, by the way. That's why I needed to upgrade my weapon later on. Or armor. And I hate this place so much. I keep pressing the wrong button in the hope to actually get up there faster. But that's not in this Dark Souls. Oh. Let's heal up. There we go. Oh, we got a better helmet, though. Oh, come on, wrong one. Helm worn by hollow soldiers may all about... Oh, it's the same description as the other one. Not too bad. I'm not going to jump down. There we go. Faster way to get down. How did this guy die? Oh, he just got knocked on his... Oh, okay. He's getting up. He's getting up and he's dead. And it will become apparent why he's dead in a second. That guy. Now run, because I don't want to be down here when he comes rushing. Okay, get up there, get up there, get up there, get up there. This is our first official boss, because I don't really count the Asylum Demon as a boss. And there we go. I don't know if he's particularly weak to lightning, but it works, and ow. Where am I? And I'm dead. I couldn't even see where I was. Darn it. Okay, let us try this again and pick up our souls just in case, because we do want to level up after this. And apparently I still have some folks that were trying to come after me. That's one down. Could you please not? There we go. So let's head down again. I don't know if I'm going to do the plunging strategy again. I might just do the strategy of just ordinarily killing him. Nah, I'm going to do the plunging one. Why not? Let's use the mechanics put in the game for us. Okay, run. You don't want to get hit by him now. And please not die this time. Probably one of the mistakes I made is staying locked on. Which can be a problem here, because it's a really narrow space. Okay, unlock. Let's get the hell out of here. Okay, come on. What? This is so narrow, it's annoying. There we go. Damn, that did a lot of damage. I didn't know he could actually hurt you by turning and pushing you, basically. Got a homeward bone, that is good. That's good, that means that our suicide run is not really going to be a suicide run in a bit. But apparently he is really weak to lightning. So let's continue on and meet one of our good friends. Don't forget this. Because they do hide some of the stuff. And that's what I meant with they hide stuff in barrels and all that kind of cool stuff. Ah, praise the sun. That will become a phrase I'll be saying a lot in this playthrough, so get with it. And this is going to be our best friend in the entire game.
Ah, hello. You don't look hollow, far from it. I am Soler of Astora, an adherent of the Lord of Sunlight. Now that I am undead, I have come to this great land, the birthplace of Lord Gwyn, to seek my very own son. You find that strange? Well, you should. No need to hide your reaction. I get that look all the time. Oh, aha. So I didn't scare you. I have a proposition, if you have a moment. The way I see it, our fates appear to be intertwined. In a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey? This pleases me greatly. Well then, take this. We are amidst strange beings in a strange land. The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out. The very fabric wavers, and relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact. But use this to summon one another as spirits, cross the gaps between the worlds, and engage in jolly cooperation. Of course, we are not the only ones engaged in this, but I am a warrior of the sun. Spot my summon signature easily by its brilliant aura. If you miss it, you must be blind.
Well, Soler, I am hollow at the moment. As you can see, I don't have any eyeballs, so I probably won't be able to see it.
Oh, hello there. I will stay behind to gaze at the sun. The sun is a wondrous body, like a magnificent father. If only I could be so grossly incandescent.
Well, maybe, but let's continue on. We got the white soapstone, which will basically allow us to be summoned into other people's worlds and have fun in jolly cooperation. Now, this is a tricky part. I don't know how I'll do this one. I might just try and rush it. Let's heal up. Because they do give you some visual hints, FromSoft. Like, if you look at the bridge, it looks like burn marks. You see a burned body over there. So, there's something bad gonna happen in a bit. And there are two ways of doing it. Triggering it and running back to where I'm standing now. Or try and rush and hope you don't die. Which is what I'm going for. So, wish me luck. Oh my god, oh my god. Okay, here he comes. I can hear it. Oh, shit. Woo! I survived somehow. It did give me a lot of souls. That's one way to get some free souls, by the way. You can just go up here. Let him breathe his fire. Come on. Breathe your fire, mister. He doesn't want to breathe it. We'll do it later then. But you can let him breathe his fire. And then he will kill everybody on that bridge. And we'll give you some free and easy souls. And we are going to go back to the bonfire right now. Because that's what I really like about this game. Is it all intertwines with one another. Like, we've been here already. But now we just did a shortcut, basically. And I really don't know what to level up. I'll probably level up some health or endurance. How many levels can I go up? Might as well go 14 on this. Why not? There we go. And I'm gonna call it here. So hope you enjoyed for now, and we'll continue on in the next one. Take care.